first law, we have two cases. If the resultant force is zero, an object at rest remains at rest. A moving object continues its motion with a constant velocity. Look at this box. When the person leaves the box, the forces acting on the box balance, but because it was initially in motion, then it continues with a constant velocity.
Let's explore different motions in everyday situations that demonstrate Newton's first law of motion. In this scenario, an object slides down along a horizontal icy ground. The normal force and the weight of the sliding object cancel each other. Therefore, according to Newton's first law, the object slides with constant velocity.
Why does the disk move with constant velocity along a horizontal air table? Between two consecutive collisions, the normal force acting on the disk and its weight balance each other. According to Newton's first law, the disk moves with constant velocity.
Now consider objects in a microgravity environment where the force of gravity is very weak. There are no forces acting on the astronaut or on the spaceship. The astronaut initially at rest remains at rest. Meanwhile, the spaceship initially in motion continues at a constant velocity.
The skydiver jumps from the airplane. The forces acting on the skydiver are his weight acting vertically downwards and the drag or the air resistance acting vertically upwards. The resultant force acting on the skydiver is the weight minus the drag force. The magnitude of the drag force acting on the skydiver increases with his speed. When the weight of the skydiver and the drag force balance, the skydiver falls at a constant velocity. This constant velocity is called the terminal velocity.
Now consider the motion of a falling raindrop. Similar to that of the motion of skydiver, when the drag force balances the weight of the raindrop, the drop falls with its terminal velocity. For a typical raindrop falling through air at standard conditions, its terminal velocity is approximately 9 meters per second.
Is the resultant force acting on the moon zero? The resultant force acting on a moving object is only zero if its velocity is constant. The moon's orbit is not a straight line, then its velocity couldn't be constant. The resultant force acting on the moon is not zero.
Let's study Newton's second law. In this PHET simulation, the force F exerted by a man on the box is the net force acting on the box because the weight and the normal force of the box cancel each other out. The box has a mass of 50 kilograms. Now, let's start the simulation. For F equals 50 newtons, the box moves with an acceleration of 1 meter per second squared. As F increases to 100 newtons, the acceleration also increases to 2 meters per second squared. Similarly, for F equals 150 newtons, the acceleration further increases to 3 meters per second squared. Now, keeping F at 150 newtons, adding a mass of 100 kilograms, the acceleration decreases to 1 meter per second squared. Adding even more mass so that the total mass becomes 190 kilograms results in a decreased acceleration of 0.79 meters per second squared. Newton's second law states that the net force equals mass times acceleration. Therefore, the acceleration is proportional to the net force and inversely proportional to the mass.
Let's explore different motions in everyday situations that demonstrate Newton's second law of motion. In this scenario, an orange is released from rest. Neglecting a resistance, the weight is the only force acting on the orange. Therefore, according to Newton's second law, the freely falling object accelerates at a rate equal to the gravitational acceleration.
Why does a chair stop when it is pushed along a frictional floor? The force of friction exerted by the floor on the sliding chair is the net force acting on the chair because the weight and the normal force cancel each other out. According to Newton's second law, the chair moves with an accelerated motion until it stops.
Let's describe the horizontal and vertical components of the velocity in projectile motion using Newton's second law. Neglecting a resistance, the bomb is subjected only to its weight, which acts vertically downwards. Then the horizontal component of the acceleration is zero. Therefore, the bomb moves with a constant velocity along the horizontal axis at all times. The vertical component of the acceleration is the gravitational acceleration g, which is directed downwards. As a result, the bomb decelerates with constant acceleration while ascending and accelerates with constant acceleration while descending.
The motion of planets around the sun can be explained by Newton's second law as the gravitational force exerted by the sun on each planet causes them to accelerate toward the sun, resulting in their orbits around it.
According to Newton's third law, when object A exerts a force on object B, then B simultaneously exerts an equal but opposite force on object A. The two forces have the same line of action, opposite directions, and the same magnitude.
Let's explore different motions in everyday situations that demonstrate Newton's third law of motion. How does someone walk on the ground? While walking, one foot applies an oblique force on the ground. According to Newton's third law, the ground exerts an equal and opposite force on the foot. The horizontal component of this force helps to propel the person forward. Similarly, when the other foot applies an oblique force on the ground, the horizontal component of the ground's reaction helps to propel the person forward.
Launching a rocket is an example of applying Newton's third law. The rocket expels hot gases downwards, and these gases exert an equal and opposite upward force that propels the rocket upwards.
Why does a cannon recoil after firing a bomb? When a cannon fires a bomb, an explosion inside the cannon exerts a forward force on the bomb. According to Newton's third law, the bomb simultaneously exerts a backward force on the cannon. This backward force is the reason behind the recoil of the cannon.
To climb a rope, a climber exerts a downward force on the rope. According to Newton's third law, the rope simultaneously exerts an upward force on the climber of equal magnitude. If this upward force exceeds the climber's weight, it lifts the climber upwards.
How does a person move forward in swimming? When swimming, each hand applies a backward force on the water. According to Newton's third law, the water exerts an equal and opposite forward force on the hand. This reaction helps propel the swimmer forward.
Why does a falling ball bounce back up when it collides with the ground? As the ball crashes into the ground, it exerts a downward force on it. According to Newton's third law, the ground simultaneously exerts an equal and opposite force, pushing the ball back up.